My name is Sujata Parashar and I am a novelist. I've written 12 books so far. But the other hat that I wear is that of a talk therapist, and that is why I am here today. Both are complementary to each other, the thing that I do as a novelist, as a writer, and as a talk therapist. Hi, good afternoon everyone. I hope you all are enjoying yourselves and no one is sleeping. Once again, my name is Sujata Parashar and I am a novelist. I've written 12 books so far. But the other hat that I wear is that of a talk therapist, and that is why I am here today. Both are complementary to each other, the thing that I do as a novelist, as a writer, and as a talk therapist. Before me, Veer and I forget your name, Akanksha, right? So Akanksha and we, both of them spoke a bit about why it is important to talk, right? And so this one is related. What we are going to share here today in my slides and the activities that we do. And coincidentally, the session is called the wishing chair. We have a wishing tree and we have a wishing chair. And we'll talk more about it later. But briefly introducing my platform. Can we move on to the next slide, please? So the Talk It Out Express, I initiated this platform. The idea came to me in 2017 and I started working on it. However, I registered my platform only in 2019. And the thought behind this was, while I was conducting such workshops with some other NGO, a lot of mental health workshops I used to be a part of, and I used to go around across the country, even internationally. We traveled for these workshops, and what happened in one such workshop, we had this couple. Now, we wanted all of them to share their experiences. So the wife would not share. The husband came out with his whatever things that he had, whatever feelings he was undergoing, but the wife kept shut. And when I asked her, she came up to us and she said that, you know, if I start talking about my thing, my husband will not give me an easy a day when we go back. The wife did not share her views for the first half of the workshop. Later on, we kind of encouraged everyone to share something or the other, and that is when she started slowly opening up and she also shared bits. Much later, after the workshop, both of them came to us and the husband said, I wouldn't have known that she had so many problems or issues which could have been resolved if I only knew, if only she talked about it, but she hadn't. Now, talking is also an art. You know, how you are conveying your feelings, your thoughts is also important. So talking is important. How you talk is also important. That became the trigger point of my platform, the Talk It Out Express, which I initiated in 2017 and registered in 2019. I have done several workshops within India, a couple of them outside India, with HR professionals, leadership workshops, and with youth of Philippines. About 3 to 4 days of workshop, it was a leadership workshop again, where the youth came up with their own issues, and you know, it was quite a success. Now the idea again, as I mentioned, of this platform is to enhance, to encourage and enhance people's socio-emotional skills and help them lead healthier lives. The pamphlets are already there in your welcome kits, the Talk It Out Express. Please look it up. You can visit the website also and you can get in touch with me on WhatsApp. Now very briefly about my organization, moving on to the session now. Can we have the next slide, please? Okay, I want someone from you I need two volunteers, one to read the quote and the other to decode. It's a very simple quote, to kindly deconstruct the quote. Two of them. And I want the backbenchers. Someone from the back. Ladies, boys, girls, anyone. Koi bhi aake padh le, wahi se padh le. We all can hear, thoda loud voice mein. Just read the quote. Uh, Yes, please. Please go on. You want to read? Yes.
Let's not forget that the little emotions are the great captains of our lives and we obey them without realizing it.
Yes. Very well said that. And this is a quote by Vincent van Gogh, who was an artist, an impressionist, a Dutch artist, who himself suffered from depression. But he turned to art and he created beautiful art when he was alive, for the period he was alive. Right? Again, someone else to decode this or just to explain?
Maybe. It's very simple language. Yes, please.
Yeah, so I believe it is all about, you know, the emotions or any feelings you feel in everyday life.
Yeah.
Which lead for you to take some decisions in your life and which drive anything around you. It could be your family, your decision, your work, or anything else, or all of us coming here.
Yeah.
And then, like, we do not realize what it is leading us to do.
Yeah.
In some way, in the subconscious mind, but yeah, everything which is happening in your life currently, it would lead you to do something in the future.
True. Well explained. Let me just supplement that, whatever he has shared. So it basically means that our emotions are our captains. They lead us to what we are doing. They unconsciously or consciously, whether what do I want to have for my breakfast, to whom do I want to vote.
Smallest of the decisions to the biggest ones are guided by our emotions. And they don't even realize what is happening. Now let's understand what is an emotion.
The etymology of the word emotion. Hum bolte to bahut hai emotion. Lekin emotion hota kya hai aur kahan se aaya hai? Emotion came from the, like all English words, you know, the source is the Latin language. This also comes from emovere. Now emovere means to move out or to move through or in motion. Even dance is an emotion. Taking action. Now let me give you an example for this. To describe what an emotion is, you walk into a con. Don't look at the slides, but just look here and understand what the example that I'm giving you. You walk into a conference room like that. You are just walking in. You haven't even, kind of interacted with anyone or said hello. But as soon as you walk in, looking at the atmosphere, your body will either stiffen up or relax. Right? It happens. Hum birthday party mein jaate hain. वहाँ हमारा बॉडी ऑटोमेटिकली बड़ा ही रिलैक्स्ड होता है बिकॉज यू नो द एटमॉस्फेयर इज सच. सिमिलरली व्हेन वी वॉक इनटू अ कॉन्फ्रेंस रूम वी नो दिस इज गोइंग टू बी अ सीरियस अफेयर. आवर बॉडी स्टिफन्स अप. राइट? सो दैट एक्शन जो आपने लिया या बॉडी ने ऑटोमेटिकली लिया इज बिकॉज ऑफ आवर इमोशन. इमोशंस मेक अस एक्ट. सो फ्रॉम द टाइनियस्ट टू द बिगेस्ट थिंग आवर इमोशंस आर द वन हु आर गाइडिंग अस. It is the body's defense mechanism for survival. Another example I'll give you is of the snake, spotting a snake on the street. You're just walking down and suddenly you see a snake. What would be the reaction? Jaise hi saap dekhte hain, kya hota hai reaction? Sorry? Dar lagega. Or? Action kya hoga? You either run away or you try to kill the snake, right?
Yeah.
So that action was because of your emotion of fear. You want to survive. You want to protect your body. So emotion is body's defense mechanism for survival. To protect us. That is inherently built. Right? Moving on to the next slide. Now we have talked about emotion, what emotion stands for and how important it is for us. Now coming to the types of emotions. Psychologists have discovered more than 100 kinds of emotions in the world. However, there are 5 primary emotions. Koi bata payega ye 5 primary emotions kaha hai, which are universally felt. Aap kisi ko bhi dekhenge, aapko pata chal jayega, he is emotionally whatever in that state. 5 jo emotions hai, wo kya hai? Yes.
Sadness, happiness, surprise, anger, fear.
Yes, you are a psychologist student then. Okay, great. So those are the 5 primary emotions: sadness, happiness, surprise, fear, and disgust. Is it a fear?
Anger.
Right. So see, she knows more than me. So now these universally, you can feel them, you can see them, you can assess. However, cultural, you know, culture has an impact or influences the way emotion is played out or the way emotion is perceived. For example, a Japanese person may not be so openly showing his or her emotion as an American person, right? Because Americans, as we know, are very vocal about what they are thinking, they are feeling. A Japanese may not be. And that is why it is more and more important, especially in this era, to be able to perceive the emotion correctly, to recognize the emotion in the other person, to understand why that emotion or what is happening, and then to be able to express and cope, not for yourself, but also for your team, for others. Right? Moving. Oh, okay. Now here, coming to this slide, what I wanted to share here was that it is important for us to give a word to your emotion, because words, you know, register you consciously. It comes into the cognitive part of your brain. For example, when anger could be simply an annoyance, little irritation, or it could be rage. So what are you feeling? Am I just merely annoyed or am I in rage? And accordingly, your action will be. Remember, I said that emotion guides our actions, right? So action has to be according to the emotion you're feeling. And for that, you need to know the kind of emotion you are feeling. You need to give a word to it. Similarly, if we look at joy, is it ecstasy or is it simply serenity? Right? So the types of emotions and their, you know, the level of emotion that you are going through, you're feeling, is important to understand. Moving on to the next slide, please. Now, this is one of the slides that I want, personally want, that should be a takeaway for all of us here. We all are talking about mental health. There is a slight difference between mental health and emotional health, and this is the difference. While mental health is understanding and processing the information and the experiences, and also it includes emotional health. Emotional health is slightly different. It is having the awareness of your emotions and the ability to manage and express those feelings in an age-appropriate manner. Now, let me explain this with the previous example I gave of the snake, spotting the snake on the road. Now, the information processed was ki there is danger. There is danger in front of me. What do you do with that information is where the emotion comes in. You either kill it or you run away. Now that action is the guided by the emotion, right? So that's the slight difference. Processing information versus expressing. First, understanding, recognizing this is the emotion that I am feeling. Then understanding it and then expressing that emotion or taking action. Moving on to the next slide, please. Now this is the activity that is the highlight of my session. This is called Find Yourself a Wishing Chair. You all are already in this room. You all are sitting in your wishing chair, so you don't have to find any wishing chair for yourself. However, this exercise is usually done by HR professionals as well as at homes, individuals, anywhere you can do it. Find a corner, keep a chair there just like this, maybe a lovely corner, decorate it whichever way you want, and then this is what you have to do. Please take out your pens and pads. And you imagine yourself that you are sitting. Don't start writing now. I'll tell you when to start writing. You imagine as if you are sitting on this lovely chair and it's a beautiful day. And you've sat down there. You've got your pen and pad. What you have to do is this word, this sentence you have to complete. I feel happy and free when. Okay, you have to complete this for 1 minute. Keep writing. That's called the hot pen method. This is called the hot pen method. What it involves is that you just keep writing without lifting the pen, which means in 1 minute, you are not allowed to think. You are just writing what comes to your mind. I feel happy and free when I'm with friends. I feel happy and free when I watch a movie. I feel happy and free when I'm relaxing. Just keep jotting down and completing this sentence 5 bar, 10 bar, jo bhi aapke usme aa raha hai. I'll tell you, the music will begin. And for 1 minute, when the music stops, please stop writing. Okay? So can we start the music, please? And it should play for a minute only. Okay. Yeah, sound a little louder, not too much.
Singing, making fun of each other. We are just in the moment. We don't think what's happening, what is our problem. We just enjoy each other's company and tell the whole week story.
Thank you. Anyone else? Yes, please. Two hands raised here. Can you please pass the mic?
Yeah.
Thank you. What about the boys? Yes, sure. And the back benches.
I feel happy and free when I am meditating. I feel happy and free when I am with my sons Kartikeya and Kavish. I feel happy and free at most when I am chit-chatting with my husband Hemant. I feel really happy when talking and counseling people. I feel happy and free when I am dancing on the music I really love. I feel happy and free and loved when I am reading and writing my own thoughts and journaling. I really feel happy when I'm traveling and at the time relaxation.
Lovely, thank you. Anyone else? Yes.
I feel happy and free when I'm with my children and I wanted to be free and alone, me time, and I'm happy where I was. I was leading my happy life and I want to be happy with my children in a very happy place where I was living right now, and maybe I'm more happy than I'm when my parents were happy, right? My children, my husband, when I'm with them, I'm more happy.
Right.
Now, where I'm living right now, I wanted a new place.
Right.
Right?
Yeah.
So that makes me happy and where I was and where I am
right,
right now.
Thank you. Anyone else? Yes?
Yeah, hello. Hi, everyone. Again. So, I feel happy and free when my whole family is together and we do activities together, right? So when I spend time with my brother, so when my wife is happy, I don't know. Yeah.
I hope she's listening. Is she here?
Yeah, I should have brought her. Yeah. Yeah. So when I fulfill wishes of my family, again, it's all about my family. Then when I work out and play basketball, that is there. Then when I like I'm truly happy, I suppose, when I solve and overcome some challenges. That is where I feel really good. Yeah.
Right. Thank you. Anybody else, or shall I? Yes, please.
Thank you.
I feel happy and free when I wear pretty clothes and I'm appreciated when I celebrate small events with my loved ones, and I'm appreciated at work when my daughter hugs, when she smiles and laughs and giggles, when I'm with her and when I help others.
Thank you, lovely. Thank you. Okay, give ourselves a big round of applause, everyone. I think we have completed a task, and now you know why, when you feel happy and free. Now, why this title? Anyone can relate to what the activity that we did and the topic, the wishing chair. Anyone can relate these two things. Wishes, small wishes that we just mentioned, can be fulfilled by us. Ourselves, and the wishing chair that we are, it's just a reminder to ourselves that these are the wishes that really matter and we can fulfill it ourselves. Now, you said that when I do things for my family, so perhaps that is also the way to de-stress yourself. If you are emotionally heavy, spending time with family will help. If you are distressed, perhaps talking with your family might ease you out. It reduces the intensity of emotions. Kehte hai na, baat karne se thoda halka lagta hai. Halka kyun lagta hai? The intensity goes down of that bad feeling. Detangling of thoughts. When you're talking, when you're spending time doing things that you love, what happens is you are able to detangle more easily your thoughts. Jo complicated hai andar. Emotion that at the top of your mind might be anger. Lekin aapko root cause nahi pata hua, anger sprout kahan se hua. Perhaps the root cause is something totally different. Helplessness. Gussa aa raha hai kyunki main helpless hoon. To aapko address gusse ko nahi karna hai. Aapko address actually apne helplessness ko karna hai. Wo kahan se sprout ho raha hai. Okay, so detangling happens. Thought clarity happens when we are doing these little things that we wish for. But we don't get the time to do that. 5 minutes left. Thank you. I'm almost done. Now, this is an exercise which anyone can do. As I said, that
in a corporate, the entire work culture depends on two things. Okay, in a corporate situation, two things determine the work culture. The cognitive part is well addressed. Smart people, intelligent people, whatever, all that. We don't address the emotional culture. Now, this helps you to assess the emotional culture of the people. Whether it's a corporate house, whether it's an institution, whether it's an individual, you want to assess where you are right now? Get onto the hot pen method, find a wishing chair, find a lovely corner in the spot wherever you are in your space, and then do this method. You will know how you are. You can actually turn this around. I feel happy and free when ko, I feel bad when. Then you understand what are the negative emotions that are affecting you at the moment, right? So this is the wishing chair. We are done with this and moving on to the last slide, I think. Yeah. In case you can't come up with anything, then wish for a blissful day. That will take care of everything. Wish for a blissful day when you start and when you end. As Akanksha was mentioning, as we was mentioning, just wish for a blissful day. That will take care of everything else. And that's about it. Thank you very much. Keep smiling.